A frigid wind blew through the dim and drafty corridors of Count Bleck. Bowser, Peach, and even brave Luigi were gone. Mario was the only hero left. It was up to Mario to stop the dark prophecy. Every world hung in the balance. What thrilling conclusion awaited our hero? Mario ran to the Count's inner sanctum, his mustache fluttering in the breeze. Welcome back to Chapter 8-4. Tippy and Count Bleck.
So, it's just us left now, isn't it? It reminds me of the time we first met. I'm so sorry, Mario. I promised you that I would help you find your friends, and now, all of them are gone forever. What? You're saying you know they're still alive? Maybe you're right, and somehow they did survive. They are heroes. I'm going to believe in them, and I'm going to believe in him most of all. Hey guys and gals, I'm Pal, and welcome back to Super Paper Mario and the Castle Bleck Inner Sanctum. Over the last 40 episodes, it has been a wild ride as I played through the game for my first time. Along the way, there was plenty of confusion. Oh my word, I'm dumb. Oh, I'm dumb. Do we need a fire pixel? No, we have Bowser. There was plenty of rage. Please tell me there's more. Oh! No! 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 And there was plenty of laughter. Welp, we tried. I'm gonna be political again. This is what happens when you try to please everyone. You get hurt. And it has all seemingly led up to this moment. There are no more cronies to stand in my way between Count Bleck, although they're enemies, I guess. But they're not really cronies. And in fact, I'm just going to try to avoid them all here. Oh yeah, I can flip into 3D. And yeah, it's seemingly led all up to this moment. They're even healing us up before the final battle. Wow, we're really here. This is it. This is the final walkthrough, avoiding some of the enemies that are meant to poison you. And actually, they're meant to poison you and they give you things that cure the poison. That's kind of interesting. But yeah, we're here, I think. We're really close. Man, it has been, whoa, Magic Blocks, hello. It has been quite the wild ride. I have definitely enjoyed this game, and you guys have seemingly enjoyed the Let's Play. And I'm a little bit more of a fan of playing games blind on the channel now. Where am I going? Oh, I know what I'm supposed to do. Tippy, there's a door here. Yes, there is. Haha, there's a hidden door here. Let me make it visible for you. So does that mean I could just use the door even if I couldn't see it? Because, I mean, she's not bringing it into existence. It's just invisible somehow. So I could probably open the door, maybe, if this game was logical. Let's see, that's probably death down there. Yeah, probably death down there. Also, this is cool, man. We haven't really encountered anything like this before. Let's jump. Oh, boy. This is really cool. Wait. Oh, there's a thing blocking my way. Oh, man, this is a very cool idea. I am a fan. Okay, let's jump on here. It's also kind of amazing that despite there just being black and white, you can tell, you know, where you're going. Oh, never mind. Oh, no, I was right, and then I fell. But yeah, you can actually see where the platforms are, which is kind of impressive considering, like I said, it's just black and white. Oh, that's cool. This is such a cool idea. I like this. Okay. The level design is getting quite good. Oh, this isn't going to crush me, is it? No, it's an elevator. A la Super Mario Bros. 3, which is a great game. I actually love it a lot. Speaking of great games, did you guys see the announcement of the Nintendo Switch, the newest Nintendo console? Yeah, the Wii U is not really old news, but they're moving off the Wii U, the old U. Whoa, jump! Man, this is really the original Mario Bros. Now. This is awesome. But yeah, the Nintendo Switch looks kind of cool. Oh boy, what did I hit? Oh boy. No. What did I hit up there? There's just an enemy off screen that I hit. That's sad. But yeah, the Nintendo Switch is a thing, and actually, I was more hyped for what I saw them playing on the trailer than what they than the actual console, because I saw them playing Skyrim, and that made me really happy. Also, this is locked. So there's a key somewhere. Okay, I guess we're going to find a key now. But yeah, they were playing Skyrim on the Nintendo Switch, and then they said that Bethesda is teaming up to put games on the newest console, so like launch titles or whatever. So that's really cool, and it actually didn't look like just vanilla Skyrim. It looked like Skyrim Remastered, which is really awesome, because I have never played an Elder Scrolls game, and where am I going? What am I doing? Oh, there's a pipe! Oh, that's so cool. Let's go down the pipe. As we're waist deep in a platform. And presumably this is where the key is found. Maybe? Is that a gap? That's weird. What is that? There's a gap. Do we need Slim? That would be crazy if we needed Slim. I mean, actually bonkers, because we have barely ever had to use Slim. No, it's not Slim. I can't see anything here. Maybe we need Dottie. Let's try Dottie. Here we go. We also haven't had to use Dottie much this adventure. Oh, it is. Okay, so we do have to use Dottie. And we're going through a tiny tunnel, as we're tiny, and will this be a... It seems kind of far-fetched to be a key. It almost feels like it's just a random secret. No, it's indeed the key. Huh. They hid that pretty well, actually. I mean, you can't see the opening. The only thing you can see is that there's a gap in the lines on the wall. So they hid that very well. So that's kind of cool. Normally, it feels almost linear with how you get the key. It's like, oh, there was a branching path. This branching path has a door on it, and it's locked, so we have to go down the other branching path. But no, this makes sense. Okay, yeah, I guess I'll go back to Carrie. Where am I going, though? Oh, there it is, okay. I was wondering where that platform was, and there will be another one coming up. Yes, there will. And we'll go on this one, and it'll bring us up to the top. Very nice. There we go, we have the key. So it looks like there's a little bit of level left before we face Count Bleck, but it's nothing too difficult. In fact, this may be the final lead up. It might be. I mean, if they heal us up, then we know. Oh, whoa, hello. Hello, enemy. That enormous white beast is the legendary Mega Mooth. HP is 200, attack is 8. They can trample nearly anything. It has a huge amount of HP, so it'll be very hard to take down. They are gods among mooths. Which makes me definitely motivated to take that thing out. Barry, no, we deal double damage now. So let's use Kudge and see if that'll... No. Did that... Okay, that doesn't work. It was kind of funny because sometimes randomly my hand, which is on the side of the Wiimote, will reflect the pointer and make the game think that I'm trying to tattle something with Tippy. So sometimes I can... Okay, that was kind of cheap. Can I just do this? Actually, if it has 200 HP, that means it's almost dead. Come on. Come on, buddy. I really wish I had Bowser right now. So it is really hard to jump on these guys. And that's why I'm not styling, because I think that would throw me off too much. Although maybe I should. Okay, come on, buddy. Jump. There you go. You're almost dead. No! Nice. And I killed it. What did I get? I got a bone and cut. A legendary piece of meat that briefly doubles your attack. Okay. Is that... How many points did it give me? And also, how close am I to a level up? Oh, nope. There. Okay. I'm not that close to a level up. But I don't know. Maybe I want to do this. I mean, it would... Actually, yeah, because there are more enemies, so... I will try to get a level up here. Will I cut it out? Maybe. It depends on how long this episode ends up being, so it's a call for future pal to make. And also depends on how quickly I killed the enemy. Ow. Got two good hits in there. I feel like they're going to heal me up, so... It doesn't really matter, and... Let's drop the bone and cut. use the kill mango. And then grab the bone and cut, and actually, let's use the bone and cut. Make this a little bit quicker. My attack is increased. So it's doubled, right? So I'm gonna deal mad damage. Nice. This is definitely good damage. In fact, I'm going to four hit this enemy. And it's dead, and it didn't drop anything. But it gave me some points, which is nice. Whoa, how did I jump on it there? I totally hit the side. Man, the hitboxes for these enemies are weird. Also, I'm about to die. But I really don't care. Because I have healing items, so that's good. Okay. Any other enemies? Since actually... No, we're still not even close to a level up. Okay. So I guess I'll just pass the enemies up now. Because it's not really worth it. I feel that they're going to heal me up, probably, with an Ultra Shroom. Hidden block. No, they never really do that either. They never really give me hidden blocks to heal up on. I mean, hardly ever. Oh, I remember this part. Wow. How do I remember this part? Oh, this is actually, it's really nice that I have the unlimited 3D meter, because this is a 3D maze. So if I didn't have this, my life would be very miserable right now. Okay, there's nothing over here. So it's a 3D maze, and there are enemies intermingled throughout, but it doesn't really even matter because, I mean, also the game's lagging a little bit, because I can go in 3D. Okay, let's just jump on them. Probably making it a little bit more difficult for myself, but whatever, that's fine. I don't even really want to bother killing them. These ones can flip. There's a slow curse you there. I think there are some chests in these rooms too, so I need to fully explore them before moving on. Oh, there's a door. Oh, I didn't mean to go through the door. No. Please don't shut behind me. Wait a minute. Oh, it's more of a maze. Did that bring me back to the beginning? I think it did. Wow, okay. Or did it? I can't really tell. These rooms all look alike. Oh no, there's a chest. Okay, so it's a different part of the maze. And we get a Super Shroom Shake, which I'll gladly drop the Bone and Cut for that. Though you can make pretty good items with the Bone and Cut, it's really not worth it at this point because obviously I'm at the end of the game. Let's see, what is in here? Not a chest, but another empty room? Odd, so it's just a dead end. What about here? Oh, no. No skills. Okay. Well, actually, that doesn't really affect me because I'm not going to flip back to 2D anytime soon. So, that really didn't do anything. Okay. As long as they don't send me back to Flipside, because that was jerkish the one time it happened. Okay, one of those weird enemies that glitches. And another door. Let's go through the door, I guess. Okay, what's in store? Through the door? Is it more maze? It is, and now I can't flip. Can I wait for this thing to go away? Oh, it just went away. Okay, cool. Where am I going? Through here? Yeah, sure. Why not? Through here. Alright, where am I going? This is thrilling commentary, by the way. I already talked about the Nintendo Switch, so... I'm mainly just thinking, oh man, the Ruby Volume 4, the first episode, comes out today, and I have no clue when in the day, so I'm just kind of... Where am I going? Let's go back. No, I don't want to go back. I don't want to backtrack yet. But yeah, it comes out today, so I'm just kind of... I'm hyped for that, but at the same time, I'm hyped for the end of this game, so... I'm kind of torn. Okay, where are we going? Was that just a straight-up dead end? The more I go through here, the more it feels like it is. Dead end. Let's go to the end of this. Go through here. Oh, no, no, no. This is new. There's a chest in there, but what else is here? Nothing. Okay, so there's a chest here. So I guess I'm accidentally getting... Get the chest. I'm accidentally getting all of the treasures here in this area. Oh, that's nice. I have two of these now, and I'll gladly drop a bone and cut for that. Actually, you know what? No. Drop this. And then we'll use the bone and cut so it doesn't go to waste, because it's still essentially steak, and I'm not going to pass up steak, because steak is good. And it's something that I don't really have in this, in fall anymore, because it's fall, and you can't really grill steak. Also, I thought I saw stairs in the distance. Did I not? No, I didn't. But there is another door, so we'll go through the door. Am I solving this, or am I just leading myself into a giant dead end? It looks... Oh, I think I solved it. Okay, so... Yeah, there are stairs. So I came to the end of it. I don't know what I missed in this, in there, but I think I got some pretty good items, so I won't complain. And now they're going to... Yeah, there's a save block. Oh, and they're... And I'm fully... Almost fully healed. It's all led down to this. Okay, I'm actually going to save here, because it's good to be careful, and I already have this file backed up, so... Here it is. The final battle, I presume. This game's still blind for me, so I don't know, but I feel strongly that... Yeah, this is it. I feel something very, very powerful. Is it the Chaos Heart? Bleh. I see you've come at last. So you're really the hero of the Light Prognosticus. Count Bleck. But you are far too late to stop the Dark Prognosticus and me, Count Bleck. Our worlds will soon end. Come to grips with that now, for you cannot stop it. I suggest you make yourself comfortable and enjoy this one final spectacle. But why? Do you really want to destroy everything? Why would you do this? How could you do this? Count Bleck does not care about any world. They are all meaningless. Better that I destroy them. Better yet, I shall make it as if they never existed at all. If the worlds have no meaning, was our meeting meaningless as well? Answer me, Blumiere. You know the answer, dear Timpani. Count Bleck does not have to tell you. But the hour has grown too late. You should know that by now. Blumiere. My love, Blumiere. Or rather, Count Bleck. The only way we can stop this is to defeat you. And that is exactly why Mario and I have come here. To stop this. Bleck. Very well. But I will also do what I must. Count Bleck is the leader of worlds. My fate is written in the Dark Prognosticus. Do not think for a moment that I will hesitate to strike you down. All now ends. Blumiere. My Blumiere. Leave me, Nastasia. I will deal with these two alone. But... Count Bleck demands it. I will not say it again. Yeah, right away, Count. Are you prepared, hero? Our duel will be worthy of the last clash the world will ever see. And we're in the battle with Count Bleck. You might recognize this room, or at least I did, as the room that all the cutscenes with the minions have taken place. Okay, I'm sucked into a black hole. So yeah, that's kind of interesting. He's been waiting in this the entire time, and okay, he's protected by the Chaos Heart. Okay, we literally can't hit him. All right, I guess we're just gonna stare at each other. Wait, what? Is he glitched? There we go. That was actually pretty funny. We were just like, we just had this moment where we were just chatting about life, and but we were both really hyped about Ruby. Except he was kind of sad because he destroyed the creators. Or he's about to, I guess. How laughable. Is that all the heroism you can muster? Let me show you true power. Our attacks aren't doing anything. He's being shielded by the Chaos Heart. Alright, now he's moving around and we can't hit him? And if you look there, I couldn't get hit by him. That was weird. You can't so much as tug on the cape of Count Bleck. You have failed. Mario, your attacks aren't working at all. Bleck, I expected more potency from the Hero of Prophecy. I will watch your game end, and then your precious worlds will end soon after. Is this the end? Oh, come on, you're giving up already? Who's talking? Hey, he's alive! Or maybe... maybe it's what's-her-name, Mimi. We can never really tell anymore.
Come on, man up a little. You never give up this easy when you attack my castle. Bleh-heh-heh. So you are alive then?
We would never let you destroy everything, you awful count.
Yeah, you would tell him, a princess. We aren't to let you go and get away with this. Somehow I'm still alive, even though someone suicide bombed me. I have no clue how I survived. We aren't giving up. You'll never win.
You're all here, but how? My thoughts exactly?
I fell through the floor before I got flattened by the ceiling.
I fell through too and landed right on Bowser. It was a surprisingly soft landing. Even though I landed on spikes, which makes me think that she is actually fake and Mimi.
I don't even know what happened, bro, but the princess found me out the cold. That's very suspect.
Okay. And I'm not the only one who thinks that it's suspect. You guys in the comments were also... you guys were also pretty suspicious of Luigi and Dementio being alone, so we'll see how this pans out.
But we're all here now, so let's do this.
You heard him. Now you've got to deal with all of us. I'm a Bowser. Bleh. When the four heroes are united, it is all as foretold. What? What's this?
What is now happening to Count Bleck?
We have the Chaos Emeralds. We shall now become Mario.
The Pure Hearts.
Bleh, huh? My barrier is gone?
Four heroes unite. Their hope burns forth light to shatter the walls of blight. Just like Merlee said.
So be it, says Count Bleck. But don't celebrate just yet. Your precious worlds aren't safe until my last breath. Let us finally end this. Now, the true battle begins with Count Bleck.
Alright, the Pure Hearts have done their job, now let's actually fight and switch over to Bowser! Bowser carry, baby, berry carry! Maybe, baby, I don't know. Oh snap, black holes again. Wow, that did a lot of damage this time. Last time it did 3 damage, and this time it's dealing a lot more. Alright, but good thing is, we deal double damage, and now I'm slowed down. Okay, so that's, he has that effect. No, 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 no. Yes. What on earth? I can fly. How can I fly? Okay. I can fly, I guess. That's kind of neat. All right, where'd he go? Where'd he go? I'm still slowed down, but now I'm fast. Okay. Let's try to get him with fire. Where'd he go? There he is. Let's burn him. I got his clone. Okay. He's LeBlanc. Woo. Run away. Ow. Alright, so he can fly around, it seems. No, 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 no. Run through the air. Run through the air. There we go. I got out. Alright, let's jump on him. Yeah! That's what you call a tech chase right there. Or I guess reading the teledash. Oh, I'm slow again. Bowser's not really working out, but it's maybe because I'm just not used to it. No, 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 run. Run in the air. Run in the air like you just don't care. And then throw your arms around and flail them. There we go. I got out, and I'm still slow, which is much worse than I thought it would be. But with the power of double damage, Count Bleck's defeated. Kind of anticlimactic, considering I hit him twice.
Bleh.
I kind of feel like I shouldn't have completed the Flopside Pit of 100 Trials, because it's making boss fights kind of laughably easy. Or maybe I just shouldn't be using Bowser, because if you think about it, I'm dealing quadruple damage with Bowser. So I think I'm going to stop using Bowser if there's another battle.
Excellent.
Count?
You have won. Now finish Count Bleck. Dispatch me and the Chaos Heart will disappear. The prophecy will be undone.
Why does it have to end like this? Timpani, when you vanished, I searched long for you. I never gave up looking. I searched and searched. But I never found you. Without you, the world held no meaning or joy. So I used the forbidden prophecy of the tribe of ancients to end all worlds. I wanted to destroy everything that had taken you away from me. But I am here now. No one can keep us apart anymore. Don't you see? It is too late. Count Bleck has done so much evil. It must end. Just knowing that you are still alive, and knowing that the world you still live in will continue, it gives me peace. I do not have long to live. You must end my game before the void destroys all. But we're finally together again. Count, look out!
What?
Nastasia. Silly assistant. Absorbing my attack to protect him? What an adorably hopeless gesture. I was about to give him the everlasting peace he so desperately wants. Dementio? You're alive? Of course, this is my moment. Even if the Count dies, the Chaos Heart won't disappear if I continue to control it. But I needed the power of the Pure Hearts to beat him. I couldn't do that on my own. So, I had you do all the sweaty labor for me. And you even used your Pure Hearts to defeat Count Bleck. If they make greeting cards to thank people for helping with evil plans, I owe you one. I mean, considering how diverse greeting cards are nowadays, there's probably one. Maybe, I guess? What are you saying? I'm saying that you no longer have value to me, so I'm ending your games. They're all yours, Mr. L. Huh? Uh-oh, Akka, why am I flapping my arms? Oh, this isn't the good, That's a way to make a serious scene not serious. I am a Mr. L. Master Dementio, what is your bidding? Wait, Bowser's also Mr. L, I guess.
Well, when did this happen?
When I sent Luigi here, I planted a seed in the fertile soil of his unconsciousness. Now that seed has sprouted spectacularly. Mr. L, run along now and get ready for your big entrance.
Wow, okay.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, get ready for the greatest magic show you'll ever see.
Also, you remember when I said the music wasn't that memorable? This is where that statement is not true. This song is very memorable. It has a mix of Dementio's theme and a little bit of Mr. L thrown in there. Like, it perfectly personifies how the story just took such a drastic turn. And it's equally epic. Green!
Luigi?
The Dark Prognosticus says he's the ideal host for the power of the Chaos Heart. And now I'm going to add my own power to this spicy little concoction.
No, stop.
Count Bleck, you looked so tattered and pathetic. I nearly forgot about you. I'll squeeze the life out of you later. Just wait over in that dimension, okay? Great. Now the Chaos Heart is mine. I will use this to destroy all the worlds and create a perfect and new ones. So, shall we get started? I have all I need to become the king of all the worlds.
Alright, like I said, we're not going to be using Bowser here. I feel like, in fact, if I can look at my stats here, if you look at my attack, right? Bowser does double damage than any other party member. And now he does double that double damage. So he's kind of OP right now, so I think that it would be fitting if I ditched him. There's an after game to this game, and I'll use him then. But for now, I'm going to ditch Bowser. So we're going to be using Mario from here on out. Maybe, actually, you know what? Actually, it's a good idea. Let's use Peach, because I feel like she would be very useful in these platforms. So we're using Peach now. And it looks like he is protected by
hitboxes, I guess, because I totally jumped on him there and it did not count. Let's land on him. And he's indeed protected by the barrier that Count Bleck was before. Although this one looks a little bit more impenetrable. Okay, wait, what? Looks like it won't open. Or why would we open it? Okay, I'm kind of stuck. Jump on this. Oh man, I stopped him. Oh boy. Get out of the way. Run. I'm kind of stuck here. Come on. Get back your platform. I can't get out. Okay, run. Oh, okay. I guess we're just gonna switch to Mario and get out of here. He is even in 3D and he looks really weird in 3D. He looks kind of whopper-jawed, but I guess that kind of adds to the factor that he's Mr. L, and apparently Mr. L is the chosen one, and he's also Dementio, this weird jester that's deceived all of us from the beginning. So it's kind of fitting. Let's see if I can actually do something here. There we go. Ahaha, I am now invincible. There is nothing you can do. And now it is time for the destruction to the begin. Let it begin with you, for you as you wallow in helplessness like an upside-down turtle. L power! The worlds tremble. Has the end finally come? How unfortunate. Is that all they have to say? There's no screaming? They just say it's, oh man, I guess we did our best. We're dead now. Bye-bye. Well, I guess this is the reverse of Earthbound and all the other games where we see everyone channeling their power to help fuel the spirit bomb. It's kind of a reverse spirit bomb as they're all just melted away. It's not even that they're dead. It's not even that they're in subjugation. It's that they cease to exist. We have to do something. We have to save Mario and the others. We cannot. Without the pure heart, there is no way to counter the chaos heart. All we can do is give up. What are you saying? You promised me we would find happiness together. Was that all just a lie? It was no lie. But without the pure hearts, all worlds are doomed. What can we do? Blumiere, snap out of it. How can you think it would end here after we have suffered without each other? We found each other again because we stayed alive. How can you admit defeat? I will not. I will not give up. You promised we'd find happiness. You promised. That's right, Count. My minions, how did you find us here? Gosh, I could follow your big smile anywhere, Count. Ah, she lies like a wee rug, this lass. Nastasia told us, Count. She said you'd come here. Or she said she felt you'd be here, or something along those lines. Nastasia. Talk about going the extra mile. She even sacrificed herself to save you. Listen, Count, I promised me life as well, and I'm not afraid to give it up to live up to it. Or whatever he said, it's hard to discern his accent. So, you gotta let me help. Yeah, I mean, there's no way Dementio's getting away with this. He pulled a really dirty trick on you, but we'll always stick by your side. If you think about it, aren't they sticking up for all worlds to be destroyed and no world to be created? I mean, maybe Dementio is just kind of going to deceive us, but, like, he was planning to destroy all worlds. So, they're still kind of bad here. And he's not, I guess. My loyal minions. Now there are a lot of chaos hearts. Okay, we can destroy the world many times over. Okay, they're pure now. What's this? Pure hearts? But why? Isn't it obvious, Blumiere? Pure hearts are the very feelings of our souls. As long as we feel love, they live on. I will take these to Mario. Let's stop wasting time and finish this, shall we? Ciao! What? What is going on? No! The pure hearts? I thought you wasted them all fighting a Count Bleck. What's happening? I'm not invincible anymore. Oh, that's actually pretty nice. Now's our chance. The pure hearts have given us power. Let's get him. Alright, now we can actually harm him. It's all come down to this moment. It's been a team effort by everyone, I guess. Even Count Bleck, even O-Chunks, who's probably one of my favorite characters in the game. We're all going to team up to defeat Count Bleck, or not Count Bleck, my bad, I'm so used to that. Dementio and Luigi are the antagonists now. And so let's see if we can deal some damage. How did I miss? Jump on him, get a style, because even in the end of the world, even when all worlds are on the line, I still definitely want to style, because it'll look definitely cool when it's read back through the generations. Let's dodge, jump up on these moving platforms. I have to say, like, the lead up to this has been pretty good, but even though I still kind of remembered that the plot twist was going to happen, I still really like how it played out. I mean, this is just so thematic. I mean, yes, I get that Luigi being a chosen one is kind of weird and it's not supported anywhere else, but it's still really cool. Dementio's theme is so... it's not creepy, but it's just... it's weird, and it's definitely memorable. And this music is quite good. I've listened to this music probably the most out of any of the music in the series, even the Francis battle theme. Okay, let's jump on him. Oh, I missed. Okay, he's careening around the battlefield, and these blocks, even though they help us, they can also hurt us pretty badly because... oh, flip. Because, I mean, they can hurt us in that we're not able to jump on him, and they can kind of block us from getting out of the way of his attack. So they can kind of pen us in. Plus, they're shooting projectiles, which we have to dodge. We have to watch their facial expressions, tell when they're changing mood, and jump on Mr. L or Dementio or whatever they're called. Mr. Dementio? I don't know. Mr. D? Lamentio? I don't know. But they're called something, and we're going to defeat him. Okay, let's flip back. I feel like it's a little bit easier to platform in 2D. Got him. Barely. And let's avoid these attacks. Jump back up. Got it. And jump on him. Nice. Did I defeat him? Wow, I did. Ga? How did you do it? How could I have lost with the power of a Luigi and the Chaos Heart? And the prophecy? Has it been undone? I think your prophecy was wrong all along.
You believed your prophecy, and we believed in mopping the floor with you.
Nothing is decided entirely by fate. You know, all things determine their destinies. Goodbye now, Dementio. We'll add a footnote to the prophecy about your failure. You think this is the end? You think this is a finished? You can't stop this now. You can't escape. I've been saving a one last surprise. Ciao.
What surprise are you talking about? Is Luigi just evil for good now? Did he kill Luigi? What happened?
Eh? What am I doing here?
What's happening? Oh, he's destroying all worlds. Oh, he was stalling for time. Okay, I guess we're gonna have to go somewhere, I guess? Where are we gonna go?
It seems the end of all worlds is really upon us.
So, defeating Dementio wasn't enough to stop it?
I thought the Chaos Heart would disappear if the person controlling it fell. Dementio must have left behind a shadow of his power to continue controlling it. It won't last long, but it may be enough to ensure the end of every world.
Oh great, what do we do now?
There's only one thing left that we can do.
Whoa, that's a big door.
This way.
Man, this is cool. I don't like a lot of the times when they paint out antagonists to be strictly evil, because there is a chance of redemption for many people.
Even as evil as they can be, even as evil as they have been, there is still a chance for forgiveness. And I really like how Count Bleck was misguided, and he accepts the error of his ways, and he's willing to make that up. And it's really cool. And the party has forgiven him. They're not killing him, you know? And they're now, you know, they're now all behind this saving the world business. Hey, I remember this place. Tymphamy, do you still love me? Yes, Blumiere, of course I do. Then you must come with me. Hey, Count! What are you doing? We will use the pure hearts again, this time to banish the chaos heart. All we need is true love, and that is something I am lucky enough to possess. But with the chaos heart gone, the pure hearts and those linked to them, they may cease to exist. You mean you might go away? But I don't want you to go. All of this is my fault. The price is mine to pay. I do not have long to live anyway. But you, Tympany, it pains me to know this may cut your game short. Still, there is no other way to end this. I know, Blumiere, I know. Tympany, don't say another word. As long as I am with you, nothing else matters.
Arg, it's happening!
We must go, Tympany. Yes, Blumiere. So it started with a marriage, and notice it's not ending with a divorce, because Bowser and Peach are in this for the long haul. You wonder why Bowser and Peach never married, or why Mario and Peach never married? It's because she's already married, and Mario's just the antagonist the whole time. But it still's ending with a marriage. So, there were so many things I wanted to say to you, but I could not find the words. Oh, Blumiere, only one thing matters to me now. I never had the chance to return your question. Blumiere, do you still love me as well? Of course. I have thought about you every moment since you disappeared, but I have caused you so much suffering. Perhaps my life would have been more carefree without you. That is true. But I had to be with you, Tympany. I will never apologize for that. I know, Blumiere. And I love you. And I love you, Tympany. Hundreds of thousands of years from now, that fact will not have changed.
Everything's a shaking. Are we too late?
Wait, can you hear that? I hear bells. How lovely. The bells are giving their blessing to Tippy and Bleck.
Urg.
Is he crying? I think he's crying, which is amazing. O-Trunks is such a good character. The void's gone. The subspace emissary crisis was averted. All because of a simple marriage. You know, something about what Count Bleck said just then, it rang in my mind way more than these bells are. He said that even hundreds of thousands of years from now, that fact won't change, that he still loves her, and that he searched for her. If you look at the timeline, when we met her, she was still freshly a pixel, because the development of her regaining her memories was very quick. So, I think he searched for her for thousands of years. It took her that long to materialize, and be wounded. She was warped into the future, and then saved her. I think Count Bleck has searched for her for eons at this point. And that's love right there. Timpani, do you remember the promise we made to each other that day? Yes, I remember. If there was a place where we could be happy together, we would find it. Will you come with me to that place now? Blumiere, of course. I will always be with you. Bro. Big bro! You awake, bro? You're standing up. Are you awake? Great leap in bog monkeys. Nastasia, she draws breath once again, lads. Nastasia, hey, Nastasia. Miracle of miracles. Gra googly, hey, hoorah. I'm alive? I don't know who's talking, but it's probably Bowser because he's my favorite. Mario, check it out. The void is closing. Yes, it is proof that the prophecy of destruction has not come to be. And all worlds have been saved. The prophecy has lost its power. Thusly, the world that was lost returns to normalcy. You have done well, heroes. It is all thanks to you. But where is Tippy? I see. So she is gone. Ah, this too must have been under the guidance of the pure hearts. Both Tippy and Count Bleck, gone. What could have happened to them? I shudder to think about it, but surely when the prophecy was nullified... No. They're alive. Yeah, they're finally reunited. They've overcome time and fulfilled their old vows. Once again, I firmly believe that Count Bleck has searched for her for hundreds or thousands of years. Everything seems to point to it at this point. From how much his transformation was complete, to how long he said day after day he thought of her, and that he said for hundreds of thousands of years he would still love her. Somewhere, the Count is living together with Tippy in, happiness. And I... Wah! Count, no! I'm all alone. What am I to do now? Hey now, my wee Nastasia, I'm believing the Count is alive too. And if he is alive, lass, we wouldn't want to be shaming him with blubberin'. So pull it together, eh? He's right, Nassie. We still have each other. We can still build the Count's world. So come on, big smile. Oh, Chunks, Mimi. You're right. Yeah, I can't just sob like this forever. The Count would never have approved. We have to create the ideal world that, the Count wished for in his heart. A world of love, not war. Yeah, let's all pencil that in. An appointment of hope. Farewells are bittersweet, but as long as you live, you can never escape them. To feel sadness is to live, but as long as you are alive, the future is a blank page. And with that, I am hungry. I've asked Saffron to make some for celebrated snacks for us. Let us heal our weariness by devouring a banquet of sumptuous sweets. Oh yeah, that is a plan. Make a path. I'm Bowser. I like to eat things. And after that, I'll eat the Mario Bros because they are really annoying.
Merlin, what is it?
Ah, Princess Peach. I'm thinking of Tippy. I mean, Lady Timpani. I wonder if she truly is happy now. Of course she is. Oh, yes, of course. Well, Let's have those snacks. Man. Way to make have the game make me hungry again. I have not eaten today, and I need food, and I need to watch Ruby, and there are so many things that need to happen. I need to play Skyrim on the Nintendo Switch.
So, the dark prophecy was averted, and peace reignited, or reigned?
Yeah. So, let's try that again.
So, the dark prophecy was averted, and peace reigned. The dark prognosticus again faded into history. Count Blumiere and his love, Lady Timpani, both vanished. Where did the pair go? None know. And so, the story of the lost Book of Prophecies comes to an end. May we meet again in another time and another place.
And that's... Wow, that's the game. I was kind of hoping I wouldn't complete it, in this recording, but I did. And I have to say, for as much flack as I've given the game, it was indeed quite good. The level design was great, the story was memorable, especially for a Mario game, a series that I have disliked because of the story that every Mario game I've played has. Peach gets kidnapped, you have to save her. This shakes this on its head, and in the process, it shakes the series on its head. And while this, sadly, was not a good direction for the Paper Mario series to go down, this was a great game, but in future installments, they tried to shake the pattern that this game set into... They tried to shake that pattern up, and they kept building on it, and making it worse. And the next game, Sticker Star, is thought of as just a terrible game by most people. It just didn't do what it was trying to accomplish. And the game after that, I forgot what it's called, but it just came out, the Paper Mario game. That is also loathed as well. And while this game, people say, okay, it's no Thousand Year Door, it's still good, it's still memorable. The other games, they don't say that. They're remembered, and they're still loathed, and that's kind of sad. But my first playthrough of this game, which you guys have seen, I've enjoyed thoroughly. Like I said, last episode or this episode, I don't know how I separated them out, but there has been a lot of laughter, there's been a lot of confusion, which has resulted in you guys laughing at me, there have been a lot of Ruby references, and there's been a lot of fun. I've thoroughly enjoyed this game. I set out to play this because it would be kind of an easy thing to let's play. It's blind, so I'm not going for 100%, so I can just edit my confusion and me solving puzzles out and just have a very innocent experience. And indeed, I got exactly what I signed up for. But also, I got a very memorable title. You guys all seem to like this let's play an awful lot, and I can see why. It's a charming game, and it's almost made to be let's played. I mean, each episode began with me doing the Dragon Ball Z intro, and that's because there was a chapter almost each and every episode, except for the pits, and it's really good. It was paced out with ease of gameplay in mind, and I like the game. I legitimately do. So, I mean, I've summed up my thoughts over the past couple episodes, so I guess I can talk about the next project. It's kind of weird because, like I said, I spelled out my thoughts for this game throughout the entire adventure. And, so yeah, the next game is going to be actually the most anticipated, or the game I've been most hyped for out of every single game, I have ever played. I have not been hyped to play those as much as I have. Wait, let's pause this game here, so I can talk. From the very first Let's Play, I was excited to play this game. In high school, and you remember, I'm in my second year of college now. In my last year of high school, I wrote all of my creative writing about the project that I'm going to cover next. It's a game that I grew up with, and it's a game that I can say is one of my favorite titles ever, and one of my most played games ever. and I'm really hyped to bring it to you guys. It's a single-player game and a co-op experience, and you guys will be seeing the best of both worlds in the next game. Alright, with that out of the way, let's accept the end. You can see Count Bleck and Timpani by his side. Indeed, they survived, and somewhere, they're happy. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Super Paper Mario, and this is not the last episode. If I can recall, there is one more episode left. Do you want to save? Yes. I don't know where it's going to kick me, so I'm just going to not talk about that for another moment. Okay, it's going to kick me to the title screen. What happens if we go in here? I don't know what's going to happen. But I guess we'll find out real quick. Okay, so there's a cutscene. So it's important that's there. And this, let's see, what's going to happen here? Oh-ho, a rousing success. I worried about Tippy being gone for so long, but clearly magical events have transpired. It has been a while. Thanks to all of you, this town and indeed all towns are now safe. Please accept my thanks. Now tell me of Tippy. Have you heard anything about her at all? I see. Nor have I. It seems no one has seen Tippy at all. But somehow I can't shake the feeling that she is alive. Yes, alive. Alive and living somewhere happily, I am sure. Oh, our tale almost seemed to turn sad there for a moment, didn't it? Well, you'd been gone so long, there must be many people you still wish to see. Please take your time. I will be at home. Please come by if you feel the urge. Goodbye, my friends. Alright, and actually, he reminded me of something I'm going to be doing next episode, which I actually hadn't planned on doing, but now I remember, and I'm going to do it. So, let's see, which one is the Samur Kingdom? Is it, I think it's this one. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's this one. So, you remember how we went through the trial of the 100 Samur guys? Well, the world ended. How rude of it. The world ended before we could finish that. And thus, now that the worlds have been restored, we can go back to the Samur Kingdom, and we can complete that, essentially, Pit of 100 Trials. It's a little bit more exciting than the pits, because there's characters that actually say stuff, and unique voices to be had, and experiences to be shared. And so I'm going to be going in their next episode, or the episode after, probably actually the episode after, because there are a couple after-game things I want to do, and conquering that pit. I will be doing it uncut, because it is completely different from the Pit of 100 Trials. I'm going to be going in there with Bowser after completing every after-game thing I need to accomplish. I'll be going in there with a full inventory, and I will be beating that, and I have no clue what reward I'm going to get, but I'm going to do it in the next coming episodes to come. I think there are going to be two episodes left in this series, where I know one thing we have to do is go back to the Bitlands, and specifically Francis's castle, and there's something to be done there, and it's actually one last pixel. We have one more pixel to collect, and we're going to be doing it next time. Thank you guys so much for watching. This has been a fantastic experience. I have thoroughly enjoyed this game, and I am happy to finish it out in the next couple episodes, and bring you guys the next project. I'm really hyped for it. So, I don't think there are any more thoughts for me to say, and if there are, I will say them next time. So I'll see you guys next time for another PalPlays Super Paper Mario. See you guys then!